Hi! Today, we are going to talk about toxicology science, particularly about dangerous toxic loads, and explore a quite good toxicity database. So, let's begin! So, here is a page of health and safety security website, which provides toxicity levels of chemicals. You can read a little about this data, and after scrolling down, you will get a table with a CAS number, SLOD, SLOD, coefficient N, and substance name. To be able to use this information, let's find out what the information about. At first, we need to understand that SLOT and SLOD are so-called dangerous toxic loads, or causative factors. Let's see SLOT and SLOD factors in details. SLOT is a so-called specific level of toxicity and represents a causative factor for 0.01 probability of lethal consequences on human. And SLOD is a significant likelihood of death and corresponds to 0.5 probability of death after inhalation of toxic substance. The inhalation means that human stays in toxic environment and breathe the contaminated air for some amount of time. And the most important is to understand what the concentration of dangerous substance in air and what a duration of exposure under the toxic environment. For example, you can run really fast over a really toxic environment with a high percentage of a dangerous substance in air and you will be totally okay. This happens because of a little amount of time of exposure. Or you can stay in a room with a small amount of toxin in air which won't definitely kill you for a 5 minute of duration, but you stay for a couple of hours and you get a lethal amount of dose, and you die. And that's the principle of a causative factor, because it combines a concentration and exposure time, and gives a clear view of how much toxin entered the organism. The concentration is usually measured in a parts per million, or ppm. Time is measured in minutes. And we have an additional power coefficient, N. The power coefficient, N, is important because it accounts a so-called detoxification effect. Let us see what a detoxification about. Imagine you are breathing air contaminated with some chemical substance, and your organism uses all the possible ways, immune system, kidneys, lungs, to extract toxin out of your body. The bigger the power coefficient, the better detoxification goes. Let's compare two graphs. The first one is for methyl isocyanide and the second one is for sulfur dioxide. Both graphs represent concentration versus time dependence for the likelihood of death equals 0.01. The dangerous toxic load of methyl isocyanide contains power coefficient equals 1. And the dangerous toxic load of sulfur dioxide contains power law equals 2. For the first graph, first point equals 5 minutes, and the concentration 150 ppm. The second point is 10 minutes, and the concentration equals 78 ppm. For the second graph, the first point is the same, 5 minutes, and the concentration equals 965 ppm. The second point is 10 minutes, and the concentration equals 682 ppm. The ratio between the concentrations for the first graph is nearly 1.9. The same ratio for the second graph is nearly 1.4. So now you can tell that increasing time of exposition twice, you need 2 times less the concentration of methyl isocyanate and only 1.4 times less concentration for sulfur dioxide. to take the same probability of lethal consequences. This means that somehow organism deals better with sulfur dioxide comparable to methyl isocyanate. Well, it's time to take a rest now. In the next video, I will try to explain how to calculate the probability of lethal consequence on human while exposure in contaminated air environment is the case. Look in the description section for the references. Please press the like button and subscribe for more educational video. Thank you for watching. See you.